Hello all. Today we will discuss about interview analysis system or examination system, how we can develop this in C language or in Java. Objective behind this system is to create the application that is for the interview analysis, and the application is developed as a desktop application. There are two basic entities, one is the admin and another one is the candidate. Abstract of the system is what? Candidate or admin should be able to log in through the application. It means that the candidate can register, and after that candidate can log in with the system as well as admin can log in with the system. Admin should schedule the interview for the candidates and create the multiple question on the different topics with the answer. There are three topics in the test, and we can say candidates should be provided with the three sets. That is, you can say corresponding to three topics of multiple choice question. Each set will have the 30 questions in each. Candidate should be able to answer the question, and once done, all the answers should be submitted. The admin should be able to view how candidate performed in each section. Security features should be implemented whenever it is required, like user password can be stored in the encrypted format. In main menu of the system, user can log in as an admin, log in as a candidate, as well as register the new candidate. If user is logging as an admin, then what admin can do? Admin can manage the topic, that is add, modify, delete. Admin can also manage the questions, that is add, modify, delete. Admin can manage the test. So you can say test information like the topic 1, 2, 3, and again add, modify, and delete. Admin can generate the question for a test. It means the random selection of the question from the test, and that must be a unique question list. Admin can also manage the candidates. You can say that the modify the profile of the candidate or delete the candidate. Admin can manage the interviews. It means that admin can schedule the interview for the candidate, that can be add, modify, or delete. Admin can calculate the marks. Once the admin calculate the marks, that should be visible to the candidate, as well as admin can display the marks also. Another menu is there, that is the candidate. If user is logging as a candidate, then candidate can modify their profile, candidate can appear for the test, as well as candidate can check the marks. So these are the three options. That is, you can say login as an admin, login as a candidate, and register the new candidate. Now, to generate all these topics, question, test, we need the different data file. So the first data file we need, that is the topics.txt, in which we will store the topic ID. For each topic ID, we will store the topic description, topic instructor, and the total number of questions that for each topic. As well as we need the another file, that is the question.txt, that we need to set the question for each topic. So we need the topic ID of the topics over here in a questions. So for each topic, we can set the question, question text, as well as we need the four option, that is option 1, 2, 3, 4, as well as we need the correct answer. So we can verify it with the candidate answers. We need another file, that is the test.txt, in which we will store the information about the different topics. That is, for each test, there are three topics, that is topic 1, topic 2, and topic 3. Now, based on the test ID and based on the question ID, there are three different files we will create. That is the topic 1 question.txt, topic 2 question.txt, and topic 3 question.txt, in which we will store the test ID as well as the question ID. And we need the information about the candidate also. That is the candidate ID, username, password, candidate name, Aadhaar number, address, and qualification. Now, based on the candidate ID, test ID, and question ID, we will generate the three different files. That is the candidate answer 1, candidate answer 2, and candidate answer 3. Candidate answer 1 will store the information about the answer given by the candidate of the topic 1. Then we will simply match the answer given by the candidate with the correct answer. If it is match, then we will give the marks based on that particular thing. We need one more file, and that is the master file. In master file, we will store the information about the candidate, test ID, date of the interview, is candidate was present on that day, that is the attended or not attended. By default, we will set the no. It means that if candidate has attended, then we will write the Y over there. Then what is the mark of the topic 1 based on the candidate answer 1? Topic 2 marks based on the candidate answer 2.txt. Topic 3 marks based on the candidate answer 3.txt. And after that, we will release the score, and that score will be visible to the candidate. Basically, so we can say that I need the 11 data files over here, and that is what topic, question, test, candidate, master, that is 5 data files, 3 for each topic, that is 3 data files, 5 plus 3, 8, and 3 for the candidate answer, that is the candidate answer 1, 2, and 3. So basically, I need the 11 data files to store the data. I can develop this application in C language as well as in Java. First, we will develop this project in a C language, and then we will develop the same project in a Java. So that's it from my side. If you like this video, then please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.